Hello, I'm Sharon Lopez. I'm from the Department of Communication Studies, Mount Carmel College. I am going to present a paper today that has been co-authored with Tatsita Mishra, who is a postgraduate student of Public Policy and Governance from the Azim Premji University. Both of us have worked very hard at putting this paper together, and I hope I'm able to convey the meaning that we have tried to formulate in the course of writing this paper. So let me jump right in. The topic of my paper is Media, Texts and Child Adoption in India, Trends and Patterns of Coverage. Media texts play a hugely influential role in shaping, constructing and restructuring public opinion. The broadcast, narrowcast, and print industries, the cinematic medium, and new media platforms offer to their watching, reading public a host of opinions and ways of viewing the world. Cultural, ideological, sociological, and political opinions often come about when various media take over and burst out heavily opinionated arguments and make stigma-causing statements. Dennis McWhale, the social scientist and British foundational theorist in mass communication, discussed media as a centralizing unifying force in creating and shaping public opinion. When one looks at the concept of adoption, its policies, legalities, conversation positions, and representations in texts of various sorts, the part that media plays in the reception of this mode of creating a family is of massive significance. Adoption practitioners and researchers have studied the part that media plays in shaping the opinion that the public form on adoption issues and discuss at length about unfavorable portrayals of adoption. It has, over repeated observational studies and content analysis, been observed that adoption, like the slide itself represents, adoption is often accompanied in media language with words like abandoned, displaced, charity, anxiety, increasing returns, trauma, noble, rescue, etc. The immediate assumption that accompanies adoption is that it is an act out of the ordinary, hence newsworthy, and most definitely charitable in its attempt. A quick Google search of adopted families brings up articles that deal with counseling, resettlement trauma, and reads that discuss displacement and root search. The language of the media and the slant of adoption stories covered propagate a stigma and rarely, if ever, make a mention of seamless adjustment. Popular films imagine that every adopted child would necessarily suffer from feelings of neglect and isolation, and adoption plots ignore the universal fact that all growing children, as a natural process of grappling with growth, encounter feelings of deep sadness, isolation, and of being misfits. Adoption becomes a convenient peg to place an adoptee's developmental distress on. Unthinking statements and vocabulary pertaining to adoptive families present issues that concern not just the adoptee, but also adoptive motherhood. Adoptive motherhood. Please note that I have looked at adoptive motherhood, not parenthood as much, takes on two forms. One, that of a sad substitute for the more superior form of motherhood that emanates from having put the woman's body to good productive use. The second is a womanhood that is all-embracing, noble and capable of an expansive love, even for a child that is not biologically hers. Barth Miller, through extensive empirical studies, have found that adoptions generally tend to be successful and stable. Stigma, however, tends to get associated with adoption because of the cultural understanding of normal families, which cultural and media texts construct as meaning heteronormative and biological. Let's take a look at journalism and the vocabulary of adoption. Journalistic reports carry a certain vocabulary of adoption, which reinforces an all-encompassing idea of society's perception of adoption in general. This vocabulary This vocabulary reinforcement can be found around the reports covering adoption stories of common people as well as of celebrities. Take a look at this news article. A news piece on adoption, this particular one, came up in the was published in the Better India, which is an Indian digital media platform. This was published in May 2018. It talks about the preference of Indian parents to adopt girls over boys. While the piece by itself is factual and non-controversial, the choice of words and phrases like ray of hope, easier to control girls, etc., bring in the connotation of adoption as a task of adoptive parents being and of adoptive parents being awarded the role of saviors. Another article, take a look at this one. Another article, this was in the same platform. This was written in the same month as the previously quoted one. And it refers to an adoptive mother who, quit her full-time job last year to dedicate her life to the cause of adoption, close quotes. The dismissal of career as secondary to the call of the primal maternal instinct of a woman has had feminists rise up in anger ever since the second wave of feminism. However, this particular line, highlighted in blue in the article, reinforces a sense of selflessness and sacrifice, not only because of the ideas of womanhood and motherhood and the implicit assumption that comes from occupying these roles, but also because of the adoption angle. This not only makes the woman noble, in quotes, but also twice a celebrated woman because she chooses to take up the cause, in quotes, of adoption, thus making the story more newsworthy than one about a biological mother who chooses to follow the same route. Mr. Anand C. is the director of Shishu Mandir. Take a look at what he says. He says adoption in the papers comes out only when there is some scandal. Some scandals come, then everybody talks about it, and then it dies out. Otherwise, people usually do not promote adoption. The reason is the supply of children for adoption. To re-quote that, the reason is that the supply is much, much lower than the demand. So as long as the demand is much higher than the supply, there is no talk about it. I think our media is not so much of an educating media. Our media is a sensationalizing media. Many of us may remember the Sunny Leone adoption, where Sunny Leone was only and her husband were only looking to expand her family. But the way the Indian media pounced upon the little girl who Sunny Leone brought home and made her they became a family. The child was repeatedly spoken about in the media as someone who was rejected 11 times. I don't know how the media got that information. It's completely unethical to even publish that information. And what the media also forgets is that the web has eternal memory. It's going to last there forever, even when the child grows up. Is that fair? Is that not? Do we not need to watch before we publish things? Now, when celebrities opt to take on the role of adoptive parents, the press coverage is not just more intrusive, but also more cliched in their narrative styles and vocabulary. For example, when actress Sakshi Tanwar adopted a baby girl, the press declared that she, quotes, set an example by adopting a baby girl. Phrases like has set an example creates a certain standout idea about adoption, something which is done out of the ordinary and places it in the light of an achievement. This particular coverage shows gross misunderstanding, if not ignorance, of the law. A lot of journalistic coverage of adoption sounds the way it does because of the ignorance among the journalistic community regarding adoption laws. When television couple Mahi Vij and actor Jay Bhanushali became, quotes, proud parents after they adopted two kids, a boy and a girl, of their house help, close quotes, the couple was much celebrated. It was also declared that the couple is taking care of the children's education and other basic needs and that the children continue to stay with their official parents, close quotes. The adoption laws in India clearly state that the process of adoption can be done only through CARA, Central Adoption Resource Authority, which is a statutory body of the Ministry of Women and Child Development, Government of India, and or under personal laws that apply to peculiar situation and open quotes, adoption, close quotes, of the sort that the actors Mahi Vij and Jay Bhanushali refer to is unrecognized and illegal and can at the most be referred to as a charitable act and nothing else. The same article discusses popular telecouple Gurmeet Chaudhary and Debina Banerjee, who adopted two girls, Pooja and Latha, from Gurmeet's hometown, Jarampur, Bihar. It declares that the couple fell in love with the orphans, in quotes, at a family wedding and, in quotes again, fell in love with them instantly. The article, an article of this sort, is problematic at various levels. It is insensitive in the choice of language, and the journalist makes the narrative adoption of adoption fall back into the self-defeating loop of sympathy of the underprivileged child adopted by affluent privileged couples. It is also misleading to the general public, who may believe that being moved enough to adopt an orphan guarantees the process of active, of adoption being activated. What is not referred to here is the bringing into action of a judicial process or even customary law that the couple would have had to employ in order to formalize the adoption. On 31st August 2017, yourstory.com, that by its own definition is India's biggest and definitive platform, ran a story which was titled this way, like you can see here, Mithun Chakrabarty's untold story of adopting a child from a garbage bin, along with details of this, in quotes, noble act. The story also went on to state that this little child, Dishani, although adopted, in quotes, is the most pampered among all the actors' children. Very, very problematic choice of words here. Although adopted, and I'm quoting here, Dishani is said to be the most pampered among all the children, close quotes. This sentence reinforces the idea that it is unnatural for a parent to feel the same kind of love and affection as they would naturally for their biological children. Not only is it unnatural, but also applaud-worthy. The subtext of the piece is, of course, the idea that parental instincts of love, affection, and care kick in naturally for biological children, making it unnatural yet laudable for Mithun Chakrabarty to feel the same for his daughter, Dishani. Let's move on to popular women's and parenting magazines. Media constructs images for adoption that reinforce biases existing towards adoption. These biases are reinforced through the common portrayal of ideal family and motherhood depicted in news and popular magazines. These biases structure around ideas of the normative process of childbirth, gender-based division of labor in a family, and notions of motherhood celebrated by patriarchy and perpetuated by popular women's magazines. There is a lot more that I have written in my paper which deals with the construct of motherhood, and I know that that because of the shortage of time, I will have to wrap up this presentation. But I urge you to go back to the paper that Christ College has with it. Take a look at the paper that Tatsita and I have carefully put together, which is talking about which moves on to talk about the ambiguous position of adoptive mothers, which goes on, which also addresses the idea about the socially constructed notions of motherhood, about the idea of motherhood resting on DNA, on biological determinism. Is there something called a real mother after all? Who is a real mother? We also went ahead and took a look at parenting magazines and realized that adoption was never or very minimally covered. And I have to rush through this. I'm sorry, but there is a lack of time here. But I'll just quickly tell you that one of the biggest sinners of stereotypes, like we all, I'm sure, agree on, on our films and advertisements. Take a look at Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham, Baagban, Kal Ho Na Ho, all addressing adoption from the point of view of gratitude, from the point of view of noble intentions, from the point of view of charity, and never from the point of view of constructive families. So the frames used to cover adoption stories in the media, the ones that we've discussed have covered all of these, the ideal heteronormative family taking adoption as an alternative route for parents who are not able to conceive a child through the biological process, and all of the others that you can see here on the slide. Right now, there is activism that is taking place where there is a call for a more sensitive portrayal of adoption in news coverage, in films. The very, very recent one is this article that was put together as a collaborative effort by both change.org and WAIC, that is Where Are India's Children, which says print information about adoption agencies and helpline when reporting on child abandonment, and don't only publish information about a child found abandoned somewhere, or voyeuristic pictures of children lying near dustbins, because that really is not putting one, the media, in any good light. Two, it is not serving any purpose other than, of course, voyeurism, of course. But instead, if along with the abandoned child you print information about the adoption agencies, and helplines that you can reach out to when a child is abandoned, then perhaps it will move on to a child finding a home and a family being complete after all. So around Rakhi was when a whole lot of hugely objectionable, you are adopted humor surfaced. And, again, because of social media activists and because of newspaper, social media activists working along with the newspaper, the government called for a pullback of products that were there in the market that was mocking adoption in the garb of friendly humor. Amazon, the big giant Amazon, was also asked to remove offensive Rakhi products, which were making light and which were showing adoption in an extremely negative and insulting manner, derogatory manner. I would like to conclude my paper, and I'm sure Tatsita would as well, by saying that if only media practitioners would remember that biology doesn't make a parent, nurture does. Children don't always grow in the stomach. Sometimes they grow in the heart. Both ways are a miracle. Thank you.